Hello and welcome back to the final episode of Real Toy Mysteries Unlocked. Yeah, you heard me right. The final episode. We are already here, and that to me is crazy that this has gone by that fast. It's been almost a month since the trailer came out, and that's just ridiculous to me that it went that fast. I want to thank everyone that's been supporting me throughout this series, and anyone who's joined my channel along the way. I really appreciate the support. Again, you guys know the deal. I say this every single episode. If you haven't seen any of the previous episodes, I'd love for you to check them out. You can find them pretty much anywhere. Just take a look on my channel after this video and they will definitely be there for you. Wow, I hope everyone enjoyed these episodes as much as I did making them and showing them to you guys. But everything has to move on, so here are the teaser shots. Jumping into the first airplane of the week, we will be heading to the Far East Island of Japan again. Try and notice a similarity between all the airplanes I stop at. Should I play the Tokyo Drift? Nah, I shouldn't. Yeah, let's do it anyways. It's the Japan Airlines Boeing 787. Here's what I would have to say would be the cleanest looking 787 real toy has ever made. This model was available exclusively through a retailer of real toy models in Japan. The JAL is the newest of two Japan exclusives, despite what I said about the other one. One of the coolest features of this plane is the registration stamp on the wing, and this model was only sold as a single plane, just like its counterpart. This model has also been discounted, but can still be found at airport shops and hobby stores in Japan, and select Asian markets, but it's practically impossible to find outside of Japan. And we are going back to Australia again, mate. That was horrendous. But seriously, it only seems right that we head back to this country, considering it's been the focus country of the season. All right, awkward silence. Can you play the music? Play the music! It's the Qantas Boeing 747. This is the newest variant of two Qantas 747s, and one thing cool is that the 747 stayed in the playset for two different liveries, but the vehicles in it changed three times. The plane is available in Australia as a single plane, but is not available for purchase anywhere else, and is quite rare now. It was replaced by a new livery playset which is available globally, but it contains the 787. Now it is the third hardest Qantas to get, which is interesting because it was one of Darren's first mass-produced and widely distributed international models. And for our final airplane of the series, we will be going to the Netherlands. What do you think of that? All right, look, I've officially ran out of music to play, so I mean, come on, there's nobody else to play it, so yeah. Queen of the sky, the KLM Boeing 747. The KLM 747 is the oldest of two real toys made in the livery. The other model is the KLM 787 in the updated livery, which has a painted and sticker variant. This model has a knockoff made by Welly as well. This model is also painted like most European models, and it's very likely that this model originated from an Air France KLM 2-pack, which would give it a long production time. When the model was easily accessible in Europe, it was distributed by Premier Portfolio. Overall, it's super beautiful, and it's one of my favorites. I recently repaired mine as well.
And just like that, the series is finished. That was the final airplane. I really hope everyone enjoyed this week's picks and every other week's picks as well. As usual, comment down below with which week was your favorite lineup and subscribe if you're new. Just to quickly recap, I'd say some of my favorite airplanes were the Australian Airlines Boeing 767, the Avianca Boeing 767, the Japan Air Force One Boeing 747, and the JAL 787. But pretty much all of them were really awesome. I have to say that this series has been a huge step up and monument for my channel, and I'm proud that I've successfully completed it. Throughout the episode, we visited Australia, the United States, Japan, Colombia, and Netherlands. But we could always look towards other places. That is, if you all want a season 2, tell us in the comments down below. I never thought I'd get this far, and I never envisioned doing this series until after I hit 100 subscribers. We hope you enjoyed the series and all of the airplanes a lot. One of my favorite things about this series was the feedback I got from everyone during each episode, and I can't be more thankful for it. I would also like to thank the Unknown Collector for participating in this collaboration with me. Well, it's time to roll the credits. Goodbye.